Hi everyone, so my name is Qatrunnisa, Binti, Zabidi. So for today's video, I'm going to talk to you about a panic buying that occurs around the world. So before we go further to my topic, I have a few clips for you to watch. So this clip for me to describe to you what is panic buying. So in order for you to understand my video, I prepared this clip just for you.
Could you be the one to call when I lose control?
Okay, the reason why I choose a panic buying as a my topic, I want people to have a better understanding about a panic buying and the effect of doing this. If you have googled about panic buying, there are few definitions come up. But however, for this video, I'm going to use a definition from a Cambridge dictionary, which is a panic buying is a situation where people suddenly buy as much of food, good, well, as they think that something bad might happen if they did not buy anything in bulk. Usually, when people start buy a panic buying, when the government announces there are some shortage above of the item, hence it's a clear panic buying among the consumer. However, government totally against of a panic buying. However, according to the definition.net, panic buying is a common used term to demonstrate of individual panic buying a lot of item, fully expecting or after a disaster, perceiving disaster, or fully expecting an enormous cost increment or lack as can happen before a snowstorm, tropical storm, a flood in our venture, or government order forbidden to a specific well-known item, for example, cleaning supply, bread, food, pasta, canned food, and everything. This food as purchased in anonymous add up to a balanced potential lack or as a demonstration of a well-being. Why panic buying can bring an unexpected increment in the expense of product? This is a form of luxury as it doesn't include luxury or consumer property harm. There are a few panic buying happen around the world, for example, in 2000 and 2005, flood protests. 2005, Atlantic hurricane season, especially Hurricane Katrina, panic buying of food, of fuel, and other supply. However, latest panic buying occurs around the world that can relate, which is COVID-19, as people buy all the good, which is a toilet paper, cleaning supply, food, canned food, without buy in bulk without thinking of another people. Okay, why people do a panic buying? So according to the Melissa Norbeck, Larry Rucker, people panic buying during the coronavirus outbreak. Okay, why people do a panic buying? So according to the Melissa Norbeck, Larry Rucker, people panic buying during the coronavirus outbreak based on a few reasons. First of all, when people experiencing social isolation, they think that all the food supply will finish in no time and they will have no food during the isolation. So due to this factor, it psychologically motivates people to buy things they do not need. Next, they feel that they are unable to tolerate uncertainty with the extreme hoarder behavior. Hoarders entitled that collect more the items that can possibly use because they think that they might use in the future, but in the end, they just keep it until it no longer can be used. Panic buying will not be the same as a hoarding, but it likely driven by the same psychological mechanism. So this has happened because they difficult to believe the authorities, hence they believe that it's the best to prepare just in case things might get worse. Next is that the COVID-19 also trigger people's fear and lead to the increase in spending to the offset fear. We know that people typically feel able to handle distress. They may still end up buying more than they need, as seeing an empty shelf at their home, where it will trigger their urge to snatch whatever is left. So researchers found that some of the items in a low supply will become more valuable for the consumer and for the market. So who will be affecting the panic buying? So this creates a mass phenomenon of panic buying, and once enough people are participating, the market will completely shift Panic buying is the short-term and lead effect investor along with the company that sell this product. In the long term, it will affect the consumer as price start to drastically increase. So due to this reason, some of the supermarkets start to put limitation of their customer need when they need to buy the item like toilet paper or cleaning supply. In addition, panic buying also will affect older people, middle class and poor people. As we know that panic buying will affect all these people as not many of us come from the rich family, hence stop panic buying and be considerate to others. It's okay for you to feel anxious or panic around during the outbreak, but it's not okay for you to do a panic buying. When you're shopping during the pandemic, take a list with you and it will guide your shopping. Try your best to follow off the list. Thus, we're able to avoid anxiety driven of a panic buying by seeing empty rack or thinking of grocery stores which shutting down. All of this thought can eager us to purchase substitute of certain item are stored out. Hence, you need a plan for ahead of time. Okay, you might feel a little bit restless just purchasing things that use in a short term. This is okay because a barrier is just trial has shown that individual can endure nervousness and that change in unethical conduct reduce uneasiness over the long haul. Researcher has likewise indicate individuals who chronically hoard can endure trouble better than they might think. Along this line, why nervousness might be unavoidable for some people, for some next shopping trip, they might probably have an option to endure it. So also it might decrease of above technique L will receive. Maybe a little bit understand of a mental component supporting our panic buying can conduct or assist our rational purchasing buy during the pandemic. So, how to overcome the panic buying? To overcome of the panic buying during the corona pandemic, you should start by taking a stock of items that already have at home and how long they will last. For example, let's say you have a few canned food, so start checking the expiry date, how long they will last. So for the next item, for the cleaning supply, check their expiring date and how long it will last for you before you do a next shopping trip. So while stocking up, it's important to limit waste and be considerate. It's not helpful to buy any food that spoil or buy as many products and other, including it will bring a difficulty to the elders when they're experiencing hardship. Buying that hundreds toilet paper is a useless because it will take time to use it. So there are a few steps you might think to help you to avoid the panic buying. First of all, consistent message and framing. So avoid all the fake news from the Facebook, from the Twitter and everything about that market will shut down, that market have nothing left. So avoid all the fake news, just pay attention that all your items that can be used in the house. Next is a reduce social sharing of signal. So instead you're sharing about the fake news about that market being shut, that market having a shortage, that market having an empty shelf, that stop doing that because it will create a panic buying. Stop doing that because it will create a panic buying among the consumer. So we need to avoid that thing because it will bring a problem to others. Next, remove the signal of environment. Supermarket might change their task to getting on the web. Supermarket might change their shopping technique, which is online. So use it, avoid to contact people. So just use it, just buy it, just use it when you need to buy it. Do not use it when you think that, oh, my shelf is empty, so I need to buy a shop. I need to buy something from the market in order to avoid any problem in the future. So next, restrain individual control. So in a certain supermarket, there are supermarket limit a person to buy a toilet paper. So for example, there are one packet of toilet paper for one person. So that's it. Do not limit all the instruction by the market. Do not buy anything you do not need, or do not buy overspend of anything that you think you might need then but you do not use in the future. So in a general, among the entire panic buying of your COVID-19, the greatest thing to do is remain calm or quiet, because everything you hear in the internet, not everything is true. Hence you should differentiate between the fake news and true news. Supply are organizing all the high demand from the consumer. This could lead to the biggest market shift. Yet the greatest thing to comprehend is a must have stock that they are presently selling. So on off the chance you have business situation in the nation that is a panic buying, ensure your customer about the MS stock you have right now. Increase the production to meet consumer demand. So all the company, all the investor, all the supplier, we try to supply all the items accordingly. So do not worry, do not do anything panic buying. So just stay calm and stay safe, everyone. Because Malaysia will be kita jaga kita. Stay safe, stay at home. Bye bye. See ya.